Hey everyone, this is Graham with GainTap, and what I'm going to be doing today is illustrating what can go wrong when a web design is done without taking into consideration the SEO, or the search engine optimization of that site. I'm familiar with the website I'm going to show you here. We designed and developed it about 3 years ago, and since then, you know, it's common for people to redo the look of their site and things like that. And so I just happened to take a look at the site and I noticed that it had been changed. I got migrated to a whole new platform, and you know, a lot of things can happen just doing a regular design, but when you switch platforms, you can have a lot of big issues. And you know, I'm not trying to call these people out. If this were a screenshot, I would blur the URL, but you know, quite honestly, I don't know how to do that with video, especially multiple frames of video, so I am just going to proceed like this. So let's take a look at the site. So if you look at the site, it's a nice looking site. It's clearly a a very photography heavy website, but what I want to look at here is when you put that site into software, you know, there's a lot of different SEO softwares out there that can do something similar to this, but when you put it into some software, you know, we can see that it looks like something kind of happened, like just around this area, right? So you've got a lot of links going to your site. So you know, one of the big things that happens during a redesign is pages get merged or removed altogether, or the URLs get changed and links break. That's just something that happens you know, when it's done without taking into account the SEO. So it looks like maybe a dozen or so pages or domains may have stopped linking to this site. That's the thing I see initially. You can see that confirmed here. The you know, these things on the bottom here are showing you lost domains. So initially I'm thinking, it looks like maybe there's some broken links on this site. If we click over to the organic search, you can certainly see that, you know, they were getting some visits, and then it's down to roughly, you know, almost none, right? Two a day. Again, this is more accurate. This shows you the keywords, so just the volume of keywords that site ranks for. This is, you know, if you see this, you something went wrong. So you've got, you know, you're showing up for 400 something keywords, and now you're down to 25, 27 maybe. Unless those are extremely high volume keywords that are awesome for your business, that is probably a big problem, right? And again, you can see here, not in the top three, one in the top 10, you're not getting very much traffic. Further illustrated by this position heat map, the darker colors indicate more keywords in that range. So like, for example, zero in the first position, 11 in the 42nd position, which isn't super helpful. Now you can see essentially you're looking at zeros and ones and things of that nature. So this is something we would do to diagnose. You know, looking at this, hands down, we've got a you know, we've got a problem. So if we can confirm that with you know, there's tools like this that can actually show you the broken links, and you know, these are really your big ranking signals, are good links, right? So if we take a look at the broken links, sometimes during a redesign, maybe pages get merged and you lose links that don't really matter much. But you know, sometimes there are links that you lose that are actually really good links. And you can see here, you know, this site is about, what's it about? It's about fashion, style consulting, wardrobe styling. And you look here, and what is this? This is about street fashion womenswear. It's an older link, it's from 2013. I would definitely want this link. So this page, you can see, is an older page, and I know from this slug and just from the experience, this is an older WordPress post. If we go here, it's a dead link. So that link is not carrying any more value for this website, and so that is going to not help the rankings. And so if you get enough of those, like you see here, you've got other ones here, you know, I'm sure that these are actually legitimate links and not just spam. Let's take another look. Tourists in Toronto. This looks fairly legit. You know, if you have links from legitimate pages, apartment 34. I mean, and you can see some of the numbers here. These are higher ranking sites, right? Rue Magazine. That's a. There are people that would kill for these links, right? I mean, this is months, if not. Yeah, this is months, if not a year's worth of outreach efforts, you know? I mean, especially when you start getting, you know, oh man, there's like three pages of links. Some of these might be garbage, but there's at least a dozen, maybe six, you know, half dozen or so of good links. These don't look like they're worth very much here, but those initial links looked like they were actually really high value. So when it comes to doing a site redesign like that, you really have to think about balancing the new look of your site with the, yeah, you can see down here, powered by Squarespace. You have to think about the new look of your site and then your search engine optimization. Now, this might be totally fine for them because they might get all of their business from referrals. They might get all of their business from, social media, things of that nature. If we do a search for just their brand name, we'll see if they show up. They still show up, so they might be fine. You know, they might be fine with this, that they just show up for their branded keywords and stuff like that. So it really depends on the business, but from someone who looks at search engine optimization and things of that nature, I mean, it doesn't take very much to redirect some of these, big money links that were on the first page. Let's see here. Some of those, you know, like Rue Magazine and things of that nature, like, you can redirect those to other pages and maintain that. But I mean, on top of removing that content, you're also removing the contextual cues and things like that that go to Google. So, summary of this is to just tell you, really think about what content you're removing when you remove it and how that might actually affect your business. If you don't know, then you should work with an SEO who can help you do that. You should definitely get a little bit of advice, you know, especially if you really rely on your website to drive leads for your business. Just doing a web design to make your site look pretty isn't a business goal, you know what I mean? So if you rely on your website to send leads to your business, you need to be really careful when you do a redesign because there is a lot of stuff behind the scenes that you have to take into account. I hope this has been helpful for you, maybe giving you a little bit of insight into your own situation, your own business, your own website. And if you need anything, feel free to comment or shoot me an email.